A photo is worth a thousand words. But during polio, this one helped save lives. Ruth Tabor, working with New York City's health department, was the mastermind behind it.
It's in a very emotional disease. In terms of frequency, it wasn't that much of a disease, but when it did strike, it struck at the heart of everything.
In the 1950s, polio killed thousands of children in the U.S. and paralyzed more. Getting the public to take the life-saving vaccine to end the outbreaks was an uphill battle, especially after one defective vaccine left 200 kids paralyzed and 10 dead.
We were sitting around talking one day, and my boss, Dr. Baumgartner, who was the health commissioner, said, you know, how do we get those teenagers? I said, well, you have to appeal to something.
Elvis Presley came to mind. Tabor called his manager to make it happen.
I'm reading about their fan clubs all over the United States, and they go crazy for Elvis. I never talked so fast in my life because I was afraid he would hang up on me. I hung up and I said, okay, he'll never call back. It didn't take 10 minutes.
October 1956, Presley got his polio vaccine in New York on camera.
When I saw you could barely get into the building, I realized, you know, this was pretty big. The coverage was not only all over the United States, but it was all over the world.
Presley wasn't Tabor's only tool to spread the word. She sent medical professionals on kids' TV shows, too.
This was one of the kids' shows.
By the 1960s, there were less than 100 cases in the U.S. per year. Decades later, in COVID-19, Tabor sees similar roadblocks.
There were people who were afraid of vaccinations, but not the way they are now.
Health experts nationwide are finding their own ways to fight fear and misinformation.
If you are high risk for severe COVID, getting the vaccine is your best option.
For many, it's the fast speed at which the vaccine was developed. Dr. Armando Meza says the same trials have been done as any other, but this time they were done at the same time. Another concern? Possible long-term side effects.
There's been a lot of studies that show that when you provide a vaccine, any significant side effect is going to occur within the first 2 months.
While science is key, Tabor shows us packaging is just as important.
My attitude was, try it. What have I got to lose? It didn't cost me anything to try.
Proof that a photo might sometimes be all it takes to make a big difference. Madeline Ottoli, ABC7.